News right now. A news conference has just started regarding an officer involved shooting at an East Atlanta gas station at a Valero at the corner of Memorial Drive and Moreland Avenue around 1:30. Let's listen in.
He started to challenge the individual, giving him commands to drop the weapon. That subject did not do that. The subject actually did fire one round. That round did strike our patrol vehicle, and then the subject fled on foot. The officer was not injured at that time, and he gave description to where that individual fled to, which was the gas station at the corner of Memorial Drive in Moreland. Other officers responded to the scene. At that time, the suspect enters into the store. He forcibly enters into the clerk area of the gas station where he's tried to get inside the cash registers, actually two of them. There were two clerks inside the store. They were not harmed. But again, he did enter the store armed and brandishing his weapon. Officers were outside calling out what was going on. They could see inside the store. Then it was at that time the suspect discharged his weapon one more time while officers were outside of the store. Officers relocated themselves to a more tactical advantage. And then the suspect came out of the store with his weapon brandished, and officers discharged their weapon. The subject was hit, and then even while on the ground, the subject fired at least one more round in the direction of officers. Multiple officers discharged their weapon, striking the suspect. The suspect was later transported to Grady Hospital, where he succumbed to his injuries. Right now, one officer was just wearing very minor injuries, but no officer was injured by gunfire. And right now, the GBI is on scene. They will take over the lead for this officer involved shooting.
Okay, thank you, Chief Hampton. We obviously want to extend our condolences to the family that lost a loved one today. This is never the outcome that any officer that goes to work each day wants to see. But I do want to commend the officers of the Atlanta Police Department. From what we know, from the video that we have viewed, our officers acted bravely and decisively to protect the community and to limit the risk that was certainly at play among the store clerks that was there and other citizens that were in the immediate area. So I want to commend our officers, thank them for their bravery and their service to the city and for the actions they took today. We will try to answer any questions that you may have. There's a very few more that we can answer, but we did want to give you, the citizens of Atlanta, some clarity and insight of what occurred this afternoon on Moreland Avenue.
Do we know if the suspect was attempting to take anything from any other stores before making his way to that gas station?
His movements prior to his exchange of gunfire with our officers is being pieced together as we speak. So it's likely we'll be able to update you later, but right now we cannot say where he was at before he first encountered our officers.
And you're saying he was involved in trying to rob those two cash registers?
It's apparent to us from what we can see that there was a robbery attempt that was occurring when our officers, backup officers, arrived at the location.
All right, if no other questions, thank you, everyone. Public Affairs will keep you updated.
Okay, thank you all. Thank you for being here.
And so you just heard Atlanta's police chief there talking about that shooting. Atlanta police right now are asking, for the time being at least, to stay away from that area. Again, no officer was injured, neither were the two convenience store clerks. The suspect, however, was taken to Grady Memorial Hospital and died there. Again, this shooting happened at the Valero gas station at the corner of Memorial Drive and Moreland Avenue. And, you know, traffic could be backed up there because GBI is continuing their investigation. Let's get now to Richard Elliott, who is live at the scene right now of that shooting. Richard.
Yeah, we just moved away from the Valero at Memorial and Moreland. Wanted to show this part of the scene behind you. You heard during the news conference, we heard it at the same time, that a round may have struck an Atlanta police vehicle. This may be, we're not sure yet, but this may be the police vehicle that the round struck. Obviously, you see it surrounded by crime tape. There are investigators here. It looks what appears to be some damage to that passenger door, and that back passenger tire is flat as well. The GBI was called in, asked by APD to come in and investigate this officer-involved shooting. I want to roll some video that we shot as we arrived. You see that ambulance taking the man's shot to Grady Hospital. We learned later he succumbed to his wounds. Obviously, this is one of the most busy intersections in all of Atlanta, Moreland Avenue at Memorial Drive. So there were a lot of people around when the shooting happened. We were able to speak with a lot of them, but only one would talk with us on camera, and only if we didn't show her face. She said she saw police confront that man.
I just heard two gunshots. And then I looked out the window and a bunch of police cars were coming down the street. And then they had guns drawn. And then I seen the man come out and I heard about six gunshots. And then I seen him fall on the ground.
And back live now here. So we're a little bit north of Memorial at Moreland. We're at Arkwright and Memorial. This whole area is shut down and the traffic is really terrific here right now. Obviously, this is rush hour at one of the busiest intersections in Atlanta. Again, we believe that this Atlanta police vehicle may be involved in this as well. Again, the flat tire, the damage to the passenger side door. Police are encouraging people to stay away from this area if at all possible. We're still gathering more information. We'll have a lot more coming up on Channel 2 Action News at 5. We're live in Southeast Atlanta. Richard Elliott, Channel 2 Action News.